Things You Don't Know About Kobe Bryant. Hello viewers. How are you? Welcome to Nibir Network. Today we will discuss all about Kobe Bryant. Be sure to subscribe to my channel for the upcoming videos. With that said, let's get back to our discussion topic. Kobe Bean Bryant was an American professional basketball player. A shooting guard, Bryant played his entire 20-season career in the National Basketball Association, NBA, with the Los Angeles Lakers. He entered the NBA directly from high school and won 5 NBA championships. Bryant was an 18-time All-Star, 15-time member of the All-NBA team, 12-time member of the All-Defensive team, and the 2008 NBA Most Valuable Player, MVP. Widely regarded as one of the greatest basketball players of all time, he led the NBA in scoring during 2 seasons, ranks 4th on the league's all-time regular season scoring, and ranks 4th on the all-time postseason scoring list. Bryant was the first guard in NBA history to play at least 20 seasons. According to Forbes, Bryant's net worth was estimated at $350 million in 2016. Bryant was the son of former NBA player Joe Bryant. He attended Lower Merion High School in Pennsylvania, where he was recognized as the top high school basketball player in the country. Upon graduation, he declared for the 1996 NBA draft and was selected by the Charlotte Hornets with the 13th overall pick. The Hornets then traded him to the Lakers. As a rookie, Bryant earned himself a reputation as a high flyer and a fan favorite by winning the 1997 slam dunk contest, and he was named an All-Star by his second season. Despite a feud between the two players, Bryant and Shaquille O'Neal led the Lakers to 3 consecutive NBA championships from 2000 to 2002. In 2003, Bryant was accused of sexual assault by a 19-year-old hotel employee. The charges were dropped after the plaintiff refused to testify in court and a civil suit was settled out of court. Bryant issued a public apology, and the allegations were considered to have harmed his public profile. After the Lakers lost the 2004 NBA Finals, O'Neal was traded to the Miami Heat and Bryant became the cornerstone of the Lakers. He led the NBA in scoring during the 2005 to 2006 and 2006 to 2007 seasons. In 2006, he scored a career-high 81 points against the Toronto Raptors, the second most points scored in a single game in league history behind Wilt Chamberlain's 100-point game in 1962. Bryant was awarded the regular season's Most Valuable Player Award, MVP, in 2008. After the Lakers lost in the 2008 NBA Finals, Bryant led the team to 2 consecutive championships in 2009 and 2010, earning the Finals MVP award on both occasions. He continued to be among the top players in the league through 2013, when he suffered a torn Achilles tendon at age 34. Although he recovered from that injury, he suffered season-ending injuries to his knee and shoulder, respectively, in the following 2 seasons. Citing his physical decline, Bryant retired after the 2015 to 2016 season. At 34 years and 104 days of age, Bryant became the youngest player in league history to reach 30,000 career points. He became the all-time leading scorer in Lakers franchise history on February 1, 2010, when he surpassed Jerry West. During his 3rd year in the league, Bryant was chosen to start the All-Star game and was selected to start that game for a record 18 consecutive appearances until his retirement. His 4 All-Star MVP awards are tied with Bob Pettit for the most in NBA history. At the 2008 and 2012 Summer Olympics, he won 2 gold medals as a member of the U.S. national team. In 2018, he won the Academy Award for Best Animated Short Film for his film Dear Basketball. Bryant died on January 26, 2020, in a helicopter crash in Calabasas, California. 8 others, including his 13-year-old daughter Gianna Bryant, were also killed. Let's discuss some more interesting facts about Kobe Bryant. Number 1. He was named after a steakhouse. Though some people joke about Kobe's name being the same as an expensive cut of beef, he was, in fact, named after a steakhouse. His parents named him after a steakhouse in a suburb of Philadelphia. Number 2. Sued for the name. Obviously, Kobe absolutely despised being associated with a cut of meat. He hated it so much that after his career took off, he hired a lawyer and filed a lawsuit against the Japanese town of Kobe for full rights to the name, which would result in the whole town having to change theirs as well as the special cut. Well, come on. Would you want to be associated with a flank of red meat? Probably not. Bet Kobe hated going to Japan for press releases. In the end, Kobe had a pretty slick lawyer and they won the case. Not sure what the town's name has been changed to, but Kobe's probably pretty pleased with himself. Number 3. What's in a middle name? Someone needs to talk to Kobe's dad about picking names. Not only did he name his poor son after a cut of raw meat, but he also gave him a middle name that would embarrass anyone. Bean. Yep, Kobe Bean Bryant, named thusly after a cut of expensive Japanese beef as well as the athletic nickname of his father, Jellybean. It's a wonder Kobe didn't legally change his name the moment he was able to. Number 4. He didn't beat his father on the court until he was 16. Bryant didn't beat his father in a game of one-on-one basketball until he was 16 years old. According to Bryant, his father often got physical with him on the court, and the two would elbow each other quite frequently. Number 5. He was the NBA's youngest player in 1996. Bryant joined the NBA in 1996 when he was just 18 years, 2 months, and 11 days old. At the time, he was the youngest player to join the league. However, this record was later broken by Jermaine O'Neal and Andrew Bynum. Number 6. He made a single, but never released it. Bryant made a single called KOBE, and the video for the single was directed by none other than Hype Williams. However, Bryant never ended up releasing the single. Number 7. He met his wife on the set of the single that never was. We already mentioned that Bryant recorded a single and a video that was never released, but that's also where he met his wife, Vanessa Lane. Lane was on the set for THA East Side's GD Up video, and the rest is history. Number 8. He once came 7 hours early to practice. It's true. Bryant once felt compelled to practice by successfully making 800 jump shots before the 2012 Olympics. This took him 7 hours. Number 9. His shoe was influenced by another sport. You might know that Bryant released a shoe with Nike, but did you know the show was influenced by soccer cleats? Bryant made his sneakers low-cut because he liked how much soccer players could do with their ankles without overworking them. Number 10. Lakers until the end. Talk about loyalty. Kobe's entire career was with one team and one team only, the Lakers. He's the very first player ever to accomplish that level of loyalty in the NBA, and he went on to win 5 championships with them. The only downfall that came from this is that Kobe's actual hometown, Philly, became his worst haters. He didn't exactly make the situation any better, though, when he claimed that the Laker would home and destroy Philly until there was nothing left. Number 11. Last game. Kobe is known for his many, many accomplishments. His career will live on as a legacy that will probably never be matched or surpassed. And Kobe Bryant's stats will be numbers for the books. But did you know that his very last game was a high 60-pointer? It was considered one of the highest-end games in the league and was also the 6th time Bryant had done it in his 20-season career. When you're as good as Kobe, you better go out with a bang. Go big or go home, right? Number 12. Almost a soccer star. Kobe Bryant actually grew up in Italy. Go figure. He spent 8 long years his childhood, and even some of his high school years, there where he grew a fondness for soccer. He played in the little leagues and, to no surprise of his parents, was actually an amazing soccer player. He had every intention of taking it to the next level and going pro before his parents moved him to the States and he found basketball. He's claimed in many interviews that if he had to choose between the two sports, basketball or soccer, he'd probably pick the latter. Number 13. Better than Michael Jordan. We all know who Michael Jordan is, right? He's one of the best basketball players of all time. He coined his very own sneaker line with Nike, which is one of the highest grossing line of active footwear to date. Nike is still continuing to release new designs, and the endorsement contract is one of the highest paid to an athlete in all of sports history. But we bet you had no idea that Kobe Bryant actually scored more points throughout his career than Jordan did. Yep, that's right. Bryant is better than Jordan. Number 14. Stick to b-ball. Sadly, even the greatest athletes have their weak spots, and apparently music is Kobe's. For some ungodly reason, Sony Records signed a deal with the NBA star back in 2000. Perhaps this was a publicity stunt to try and cash in on his newly scented success, or maybe Kobe was the one who engaged it. Regardless, they planned to release a whole CD of Bryant rapping to tunes about basketball, beats, and babes, but after the first single dropped like a poorly executed joke, so did the whole deal. Fans were not digging it at all. Number 15. Close encounter with a hornet. Drafted right out of high school, Kobe Bryant was actually originally assigned to the Hornets. But just 2 weeks later, right before his first game, Kobe was traded to the Lakers in exchange for Vlade Divac. Bet they regret that now. Who the heck is Vlade Divac, anyhow? This is a classic case of poor judgment and major regrets. Number 16. Italian tongue. Kobe grew up in Italy and spent years living there. As a result, he picked up the language and is now considered bilingual and fluent in Italian. As if the tall, dark, and handsome star basketball player needed any further ammo to woo the ladies and win their hearts. All he has to do is speak some sweet Italian and they're putty in his hands. Number 17. A date with Brandy. Remember your high school prom? Uncomfortable outfit, pimply face, borrowed your mom's car or worse, got a ride with your mom. Was your date a catch or were they your cousin? Well, prepare to feel even worse about your high school prom experience when you find out who Kobe Bryant took to his. Yep, none other than hip-hop star Brandy. He even went on to appear on her show Moesha, a teen flick, as a pro basketball player. This just seems like a match made in heaven. Wonder why it never worked out? Number 18. Scored the most points. Bryant scored the most points by a single player in one game since 1962, which was by Wilt Chamberlain for the Philadelphia Warriors. Although Wilt scored an impressive 100-point game, Kobe's high-point game in 2006 was with 81 points. This makes him in second place, a spot that no one has even come remotely close to touching since. Number 19. A series of firsts. Not only is Kobe the first player in the NBA to play all 20 seasons with the exact same team, no trades whatsoever, but he's also the first guard to ever play 20 seasons, period. That's quite impressive considering that NBA players get passed around more than a hot potato. Number 20. Child prodigy. Much like most big stars, the talent has to come from somewhere. Kobe's dad, Joe Jellybean Bryant, was also a professional basketball player. He spent 8 years playing for the American League with three different teams before moving back to Italy and finishing his career with seven more seasons. That's some good blood there. Number 21. Olympic medalist. In 2008 and again in 2012, Kobe Bryant played on the U.S. national team in the Summer Olympics. He proudly brought home two gold medals for basketball and considers it one of his greatest accomplishments to date. Number 22. Ups and downs. Like the law of physics states, what goes up must come down. And you can't have as many wins and accomplishments as Kobe has without the losses to balance it all out. While Bryant currently sits as one of the highest scoring players in all of the NBA, he's also ranked for the player with the most missed shots in all of NBA history. He seems to keep his head up, though. And why not? With that many wins, who cares about the losses? You take the good with the bad, and any professional athlete should understand that. Number 23. Early retirement. Kobe retired in 2015 after spending 20 whole seasons playing in the NBA. Some snivel their noses and give him flack for being able to retire so early in life, but Kobe dedicated more than half of his existence to the game of basketball. He's won championships, broken records, set records, and is an idol for little boys and girls everywhere. How about we just say his early retirement is very well deserved? After all, the career life expectancy of a professional athlete is estimated to be anywhere from 10 to 15 years. So for Kobe to get drafted in his teens and retire in his 30s sounds about right. Number 24. Not so spoiled. A lot of people who don't really read articles or do their research, say that Kobe Bryant is a spoiled little rich kid. A bratty only child. But those haters would be quite surprised to find out that Bryant actually has two sisters, Shea and Sharia. He states that his upbringing was the total opposite of spoiled living, and it's why he turned to sports in the first place, to get away from his annoying sisters. It was something he could bond with his father over, and also something that his sister couldn't take from him. They may have gotten the last ice cream cone, but he got the last laugh. Number 25. One good thing. Remember the record deal with Sony? Yeah, the one that completely failed before it even left the ground? Well, at least one good thing came of it. While at the studio recording some tracks one day, Kobe took a break to go check out a music video being filmed. One of the backup dancers caught his eye. Her name was Vanessa, and now her name is Vanessa Lane Bryant. Yep, that's right. Kobe Bryant met his wife, a former dancer, while recording a hip-hop album. Wonder if she was disappointed when the record flopped? Number 26. His signature shoes are designed after soccer cleats. Kobe designed his low-cut shoes after soccer cleats. Most basketball shoes are high tops, and just like a soccer player, Kobe went for the low-cut shoes. Number 27. Chews on his jersey for a reason. Probably you have wondered why Kobe is always chewing his jersey during games. He is just trying to wet his mouth. Number 28. He was the first guard taken out of high school. The Lakers made Kobe the first guard to come out of high school by taking him with the number 13 in the 1996 draft, via the Charlotte Hornets in exchange for Vlade Divac. Usually teams would rather take a big man because you can't teach height. Bryant struggled during his first season, only averaging 7 points in 15 minutes and 7.6 points per game. Number 29. His New York street ball nickname is Three Rings. He gains his nickname Three Rings after he played ball against some of the best street ballers that New York had to offer. Number 30. Destiny's Child cameo. Was Bugaboo the poor man's No Scrubs, or was it the other way around? That's probably a discussion best left for a different day. Either way, Kobe made a brief appearance as a bewildered version of himself in the Bugaboo music video, briefly locking eyes with Beyoncé before she and the rest of Destiny's Child moved on to party with a marching band and get back together with their old boyfriends. Number 31. Kobe wore number 33 for most of high school. Out of respect for his father, Kobe wore the number 33 for the rest of his career in Indiana the high school. Number 32. The Shadow Defender. Maybe it sound too crazy, but Kobe Bryant knows something about beating out shadows. We have all seen that Kobe was under Jordan's shadow. Number 33. Bruce Lee is Kobe's biggest basketball motivator. Kobe appearing in the I Am Bruce Lee documentary was no accident. He's a big Bruce Lee fan, and cited him as a key influence while on a tour of Asia in 2010. It seems Bruce Lee has nothing to do with basketball. To me, it has everything to do with basketball. He's fascinated with the Chinese energy concept of Qi and how it not only relates to Lee's martial arts, but in basketball too. The formlessness concept with which Lee practiced martial arts also intrigued Kobe, who tries to play loosely, adapt to number 34. He's a big AC Milan fan. Becoming an AC Milan fan must have been a no-brainer for Kobe. While he could have picked rival Inter Milan, AC Milan was wildly successful during his stay in Italy, winning the Champions League twice, the Coppa Italia twice, and the Serie A title once. That's quite a trophy haul for young Kobe to witness. Number 35. His rap battles while in the league. Not backing down from a challenge is typical Kobe. When Kobe told Williams that he was going to go to his room to rap during All-Star weekend, Williams made the mistake of saying, "You can't rap." Kobe then rapped for 15 straight minutes before Williams walked away. We wonder if Kobe still rhymes all alone in his room. Number 36. Kobe's favorite player was Mike D'Antoni. Except Michael Jordan, Kobe's favorite player was Mike D'Antoni, who was playing in Milan during his stay in Italy. Number 37. Kobe had his own video game franchise. Those who were fans of Kobe in his mini-fro days can remember the Kobe Bryant NBA Courtside video game franchise for Nintendo. The first edition dropped in 1998, and while it wasn't on par with NBA Jams in terms of popularity, it was successful enough to garner two more installments. The final edition, NBA Courtside 2002, did go on to sell over 100,000 copies. IGN gave Courtside 2002 a 7.5 rating. Number 38. He's very upfront about his top 5. When Kobe was asked to make a top 5 list, he didn't put himself on it. His top 5 were Jordan, Russell, Magic, Kareem and Bird. Number 39. As a child soccer player, he played goalkeeper because of his lanky build. Kobe had potential to be a great keeper had he pursued it. With his hops, 6 feet 6 inches build, 6 feet 11 inches wingspan, and killer mentality, he could have dominated between the goal posts and in the penalty box. Attackers would have been afraid of 1-on-1 challenges, and any striker brave enough to attempt a header in the box would be met with Kobe's scowl. In the face of the "how would LeBron do in the NFL" scenario, Kobe as a goalkeeper might actually be more plausible. Number 40. He hates dog poop. Oh, you did know that Complex has been riding with Kobe for a few years now? That's right, the Black Mamba was on the cover of our February-March 2009 issue. In outtakes of his interview with Mark Echo, Bryant revealed the one thing he despises the most. Haters? Nah. Hotel employees? Nope. Celtics fans? No. He hates dog shit. Don't we all? Sidebar, dog poop was actually at the center of a lawsuit between the Bryants and a former mate of theirs. Number 41. When he and Vanessa started dating, her high school made her finish her senior year from home. If you were a high school principal, and the Lakers star shooting guard started showing up on your campus in a Mercedes to pick up one of your students, would you welcome it? Kobe's press sense around Marina High School in Huntington Beach, California was deemed to be a big enough distraction that Vanessa, who was a senior when she started dating Kobe, was forced to finish her year from home. Number 42. His favorite soccer player was Marco van Basten. While growing up in Italy, Kobe followed Magic's Showtime Lakers despite the 6,000-mile separation. He had his idols closer to home too. On the soccer front, he looked up to star AC Milan striker Marco van Basten, who scored 90 goals during his time with Milan. Number 43. The Clippers didn't draft him with the 7th pick in the 1996 draft. The Clippers didn't draft him with the 7th pick in the 1996 draft because they didn't think the city of LA would take them seriously. The Clippers loved Kobe's workout but decided not to take him because they didn't want to be a laughingstock. They felt that if they took a 17-year-old, the city wouldn't take them seriously as a franchise. They took Lorenzen Wright, which was a safe pick at the time. Hindsight is 20/20. Number 44. Cannabis was his favorite rapper growing up. According to the rappers who Kobe grew up hanging around, he was a very lyrical rapper. DJ Clark Kent even categorized him as a lyrical miracle genius type rapper. It's no surprise then that Kobe took to cannabis, one of the most talented and underappreciated lyricists of 90s rap, to draw inspiration for his own music. Said Words, an MC who Kobe recorded alongside, you could tell he was influenced by cannabis. Kobe had a quality of lyrics. Number 45. He lived with Steve Stout. While recording his debut rap album in 1998, he lived with Steve Stout. When hip-hop industry legend Steve Stout wants you to live with him to record a rap album, you do it. Stout had Kobe live in his New Jersey mansion so he could record him in what was supposed to be a superstar rap career. He'd train at nearby Ramapo College by day and do the hip-hop thing with Stout at night, recording with NAS, Noriega, and 50 Cent, and then clubbing afterward. Number 46. His original number, 8, is what you get when adding up his ABCD camp number, 143. When Kobe arrived with the Lakers and chose to wear number 8, it wasn't just by coincidence that he arrived at that number. Not only was it the number he wore growing up in Italy, as an homage to his favorite player, Mike D'Antoni, but it was also the sum of his number, 143, from the legendary ABCD camp number. Number 47. He says he would have gone to UNC over Duke had he chosen to go to college. It's one of the great what-ifs of all time. If Kobe had really decided to go to UNC instead of entering the draft in 1996, he would have joined up with Vince Carter and Anton Jameson, forming what could have been one of the greatest college teams of all time. That 1996-97 Tar Heel squad made it to the Final Four without Kobe, so it's probably safe to say they would have been able to squeeze out two more wins with him. Number 48. A Spice Girls fan. Wise shares an anecdote from an interview he conducted with Kobe way back in 1998, when he was just 19. They were in Bryant's car, and after listening to some Jay-Z, Kobe switched to a Spice Girls CD. "You like the Spice Girls?" Bryant said. "A lot of people hate them, but the positive image they project, how they make kids feel, I admire that." Number 49. He has created a mythological universe. At the beginning of Shelburne's story, Kobe talks about his plans after basketball. "There's an entire mythological universe I've created," he said. "There are certain rules that make up this world. Within this world, I've built in a lot of room for really talented writers to come in." Turns out he's met with people like J.K. Rowling, the author of the Harry Potter series, and J.J. Abrams, director of Star Wars, The Force Awakens, among other things. Number 50. He, don't, got game. Back in the summer of 1997, after Kobe's rookie season, director Spike Lee offered him the role of Jesus Shuttlesworth in He Got Game alongside Denzel Washington. Bryant passed, choosing to focus on working in the gym that summer. Lee cast Ray Allen instead. Number 51. Classical genius. Kobe can play the piano, and he taught himself how to do it. A couple of years ago, he wanted to learn how to play something for his wife, Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata, to be more precise. But he wanted to challenge himself, too. "Sitting down and taking lessons would be too easy," Bryant said. "So I taught myself by ear." Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button below, and please don't forget to share this video with your friends.